So what's going on, guys? It's JM at Sweetboxing. Make sure you subscribe to my channel before you click on 20 of my videos. Also, comment below in the comment section if you guys have any opinions of what I'm saying in any of my videos. It really does help me out. If you guys could drop me a quick sub or two on my channel. So, the promoter of Anthony Joshua, Eddie Hearn, says that the likely fights for Anthony Joshua in October when he next steps into the ring are the Kubrat-Pulev fight or the rematch with Vladimir Klitschko. He says, well, he basically says that if the Vladimir Klitschko fight doesn't happen next, then it's going to have to be Kubrat-Pulev. When asked about the Luis Ortiz fight, he says that that fight can be put on ice at the moment. So recently Luis Ortiz came out and said that he was considering taking legal action against the WBA for them messing him about if he doesn't get a shot at Anthony Joshua next. But Eddie Hearn didn't seem to mention this in the interview at all. All he said was that fight can be put on ice. And I'd like to see the Vladimir Klitschko rematch. And I think if Vladimir Klitschko can get himself motivated again, because let's be real, he was very close to beating Anthony Joshua in that fight. In that sixth round when Anthony Joshua was very hurt, all Klitschko had to do was connect one or two more shots and I think Anthony Joshua would have been out of there. But obviously Anthony Joshua showed a lot of heart, Klitschko played it too cautious, and then Anthony Joshua rallied on and managed to get the knockout in the 11th round. So Klitschko will probably be kicking himself. Eddie Hearn says in this interview also that Vladimir Klitschko is gone on holiday with his family, and that he will make a decision while he's on holiday with his family if he wants to rematch with Anthony Joshua, because he does have a rematch clause in the contract, which is very weird because you don't really see a challenger having a rematch clause in the contract usually. But it is Vladimir Klitschko, so he does get special things like this in his contract. And I would like to see that rematch next rather than the Kubrat-Pulev fight, because I see Anthony Joshua beating Kubrat-Pulev. I really do. Like, Kubrat-Pulev is a very good boxer, but I just don't see him having the power or the strength to be able to take out somebody like Anthony Joshua. I really don't. And I see Anthony Joshua getting to Kubrat-Pulev in the fight and just being too strong for him. I'd like to see the Luis Ortiz fight as well. Like, that's a fight I'd rather see. I'd like to see Anthony Joshua and Luis Ortiz, but it doesn't look like that fight's going to happen. The Deontay Wilder fight, I don't think that's going to happen this year either. So I think if we don't see the Klitschko rematch this year, then we're going to have to see Anthony Joshua and Kubrat-Pulev. And if it happens, then it is what it is at the end of the day. It's not the most spectacular fight in the world, but it is a mandatory defence and it has to be done. So yeah, comment below in the comment section. It's JM.